In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. So we hear the epistle according to St. Peter, the first epistle, chapter 4, was the reading of the Catholicon today. And that what I would like to go through with you today. First of all, the first fact that St. Peter was teaching us is the end of everything is at hand. Somebody might say, I believe that I am young, the end is not at hand yet, I have plenty of time to live. And some people might think that even if they are very old in age. Would like us to understand what is meant by the end of all things is at hand. The first way to understand it is when you think about or you compare the eternity to our earthly life. So when you compare eternity to earthly life will be nothing, as if it is a drop in an ocean, right? So if St. Peter is telling us the end of all things is at hand, he means if you will compare your earthly life to eternity, it's nothing, it will go by very fast. It's very short. Somebody might say, our Lord Jesus Christ told us that I am coming fast, and it has been 2,000 years now, and he is not here yet. Listen, don't think about the 2,000 years, think about your age, about your earthly time. Yes, he may not come tomorrow or after a month or a year, but we can leave the earth soon, any time. So the end does not mean his coming only, but it means my leaving to meet him. And we should not say that we are healthy and we are young, because your experience in life shows that anybody can be called any time to be with the Lord unexpectedly. Do you agree about that? Anytime. So the point is, when St. Peter teaches us that the end of all things is at hand, he is right. And if somebody is wise, will think like that. And if we will accept and believe that the end of all things is at hand, I would like us not to panic or not to be fearful. And instead, St. Peter in his epistle today is drawing for us a wonderful spiritual map, how to be ready, how to prepare yourself every day of your life. So the map he drew today in his epistle, and I will be committed to his teaching. I will not add anything from on my own. I will be committed to what the Holy Spirit mentioned according to St. Peter. First of all, he said, if you realized that the end of all is at hand, first of all, be serious and watchful in your prayer. That the meaning is very simple. The meaning is, make sure in your life journey to be connected to the Lord. Be connected. Be connected. Don't allow the earthly journey or the overwhelming of your earthly life to disconnect you from the Lord. Because we are living here in our earthly life as if we are a ship moving in an ocean. Safina mashiya fil muhit. You are like a ship moving in an ocean. If you lost the connection to the station, You have no direction. You don't know where to go. You will be in total confusion. So the point is, the first advice we received today from St. Peter, if we realized that the end of all things is at hand, is first connect yourself to the Lord. Be connected. And according to his teaching, how to be connected, first take it serious. Because if you did not care to be connected, you will be lost in the busyness and the overwhelming atmosphere of our earthly life. You will be lost. Be connected. Take it serious. And how to be connected? Pray to the Lord in a watchful way, meaning watchful means mindful and wholeheartedly. Connect your heart to the Lord, connect your mind to the Lord, and you can talk to him at any moment, any situation of your life. Any moment, any situation. Anywhere. Among people working, driving, eating, before bedtime. Just the point is to be connected. This is the first advice. Be connected to the Lord in a mindful way, wholeheartedly. And be serious about it. Because if you are not serious about it, the result is that you will be lost. So first advice, be connected. Second advice from St. Peter is, above all things, according to his teaching today, above all things, love one another with fervent love. So if you'd like to prepare for the eternity, the most important thing you'd like to be keen about is to be connected to the Lord. And number two is, above all things, practice love. Love people. And I like his expression, love people with fervent love. Fervent means your love will be strong, will be intense. Will be strong and intense, either in its value or in its expression. Don't be poor in your love. Be love one another in a fervent, powerful, strong love. اللغة العربية يقول إيه؟ تحبوا بعضكم بعض بشدة. Love one another with fervent love. And show your love and practice your love to people around you. I keep repeating, and I will repeat the entire of my life, that if any of us will stand before the Lord at the last day and say, I succeeded to love people, this is more than enough qualification for him to inherit the kingdom of God. Because of that, when somebody came to our Lord and asked him, what shall I do to inherit your kingdom? He answered, love God with all your heart and love your neighbor as yourself. These are the qualifications. So when St. Peter is enlightening our mind and is teaching us that the end of all is at hand, he is not scaring us. In reality, he is benefiting us to take advantage of the chance we have, to use our time wisely, to start from today, to be connected and to invest our time in loving one another with fervent love. So number one, to prepare is to pray. Number two, to prepare is to love. Number three is to give. Because of that, he said, be hospitable to one another without grumbling. You know, grumbling, يعني واحد ما بقاش متذمر. Grumbling means to complain that people are not appreciative they are not worthy. How it comes that I will keep loving and nobody is appreciating me? How it comes that I will keep giving and everybody is selfish? Your business as a child of God is to be a giver, same like your Father who are in heaven. And don't care about the response of people or about the attitude of people. Don't be grumbling. Just be hospitable. And when I say hospitable, I'm not talking about material only. Yes, in hospitality, material is important, but I'm not talking about material only. I'm first talking about receiving one another. How do we receive one another? جانا عندنا في مصر بنقول للناس لاقيني ولا ايه؟ ها؟ لاقيني ولا تغديني يعني استقبلني حلو وابتسم في وشي ويلكم بي بي وورم حسسي ان انا مقبول accepted and then later on after that if you'd like to offer me a cup of coffee the cup of coffee will be tasty correct؟ بس لو انت بقى مكسر if you are like مش عارف مكسر يعني ايه بالانجليزي if you are not cheerful and you are not warm in receiving me and you let me feel that I'm not accepted at all I'm not welcome at all and then you offer me a cup of coffee I wouldn't be able to drink it right so being hospitable means first how to welcome people, how to accept people, how to smile in people's face, how to let people feel accepted and welcome in your life. How to adopt the attitude of our Lord Jesus Christ when he used to receive the weak people, the poor people, the rejected people, the unwanted people, the sinners, the sick people, the disabled people. And he made himself like a refuge for all to come and feel that they find warmth and find acceptance. So be hospitable to one another means how first to receive one another. And then how to be generous in your giving to one another. The point is, being hospitable is very essential for all of us because everything we will give, either it's emotional or physical, those are the things which we are storing for our eternal future. الواحد لما يروح السماء عند ربنا وهو طالع كده مسافر على فوق هيسيب كل حاجة. حاجة واحدة بس هياخدها معاه ايه هي؟ هي الحاجة اللي اداها للآخرين. Whatever you give, you will find what you gave stored for you with the Lord upstairs in his heaven. So that when St. Peter commanded us be hospitable to one another emotionally and physically, he is advising us to be rich in heaven. For us to be rich, be generous here so that in heaven God will be generous with you. Be hospitable here so that in heaven you will find yourself, God hospitable to you, will receive you with happiness, with acceptance, with generosity, will welcome you in his heaven. So if you strongly believe that the end of all is at hand, and you would like to prepare, one of the wonderful ways how to prepare is to be hospitable with people. Accept people with happiness, with welcoming. Be cheerful. And don't grumble. Don't say people are bad and are weak. Just do it joyfully. And keep doing it. It's not only for people's benefits, it's also for your benefits to be hospitable and generous. So first, to pray. Second, Love, third, give. Fourth, serve. Because of that, he said, he added, as each one received a gift from God, let him use her gift to serve others. What do I mean by serve? I would like you to believe and to understand that when God created you, he created you gifted in any way. Every single human is gifted from God. You have a gift. Regardless of the kind of gift you have, yes, there are different kinds of gifts people have, but you are created by God's hand and you are gifted. God never sent a single human being to earth without being gifted. You have a gift. And the best way to prepare yourself to your eternal life is to know which gift you have and to use your gift to serve others. Believing that you are, according to the expression of St. Peter, you are a steward. أنت وكيل من الله. You are a steward, gifted by him to use your gift to serve. When you serve people and enrich people's life, you believe that you are serving according to an ability given from God. It is not about your ability, or it's not about your talent, or it is not about your... you are not the source of the gift. You are just gifted by this gift from God to use it, to invest it, to serve others. As a steward of God, كوكيل الله. Because of that, yes, the children of God are gifted, yet they are truly humble. Because they strongly believe that they are gifted, and at the same time, they strongly believe that the source of their gift is God. It is not about them, it's about the power of God. If you are serving, you are serving others according to the ability given to you by God. I wish a day will come and every single one of us will have a small service in our church to do. Because if you'd like to serve the whole world, you need to start by your family as a small circle and then move to your community and then move to the society and then move to the whole world. If you fail to serve your family, you cannot serve your community. And if you fail to serve your community, you cannot serve the society or the whole world. Here I am saying you are created by God, gifted, and he sent you to our earthly life to have a mission with him, to invest your gift in serving others, and that will qualify you to inherit his kingdom. Nobody can say, I'm not gifted, so that I cannot be a servant. No Christian can say that. You can't say that. Because if you will say that, you are denying the power of God. If you are saying that, you are denying the power of God who is working on you. Your service might be very simple, very easy. Do you remember Saint Sam'an al-Kharraz, Al-Quddis Sam'an al-Kharraz? When the patriarch Amba Ibrahim ibn Zara came before the mountain, after 3 days of prayer and fasting, he and his congregation was required to move the mountain. And after 3 days, he needed help. He needed a spiritual help. And St. Mary from her icon at the church talked to him and told him what? Go outside the church. You will find a man with one eye. Okay? Carrying what? carrying a sack of water, like a container of water. Why Saint Simon was carrying a sack of water? What was he doing? His service was to wake up very early in the morning, to go to the well, to transfer water to the houses of the elderly people and the disabled people out of love. This was his service, is to deliver water. Okay? And he kept doing his service for many, many years, many years. Who was watching from above? God. How God evaluated his service? Maybe greater than the service of the patriarch himself, right? So that he commanded Bob Abraham ibn Zara and told him, who will move the mountain is Saint Sam'an. He is walking outside now. Go and just catch him. When Saint Sam'an came and he bowed with the congregation, the mountain moved. What was his gift? What was his service? What was his gift? What was his service? This is my question for you. Yeah, he was not, I mean, he was not gifted to be a deacon, to be a Sunday school teacher, to be a leader, to do something like great in people's eyes. His gift was very simple, that his heart was filled with love, and he went out to take water from the well and to transfer the water into the houses of the elderly people and the disabled people. He was not doing something great according to people. But in God's eyes, he was the greatest. So when you come to the church to serve your community or at home to serve your family, don't say, I need to be gifted and talented to perform an amazing service. Just come with your heart and use your simple talent in a very simple way, and that will be more than enough and great in God's eyes. ماشي؟ يعني لو واحد جه الكنيسة كده الصبح اتكلم معاكم عن حاجة لطيفة بالعربي شوية. عم ناجي راح فين؟ راح السما. كويس؟ عم ناجي كان بيجي الكنيسة امتى؟ بالظبط بالدقيقة ها؟ 9:15. كويس؟ عم ناجي تنيح صح؟ من كام بقاله قد ايه شهر دلوقتي مثلا او 3 اسابيع عم ناجي تنيح. انا كنت باجي الكنيسه الاقي فاتح باب الكنيسه، دلوقتي بلاقي الكنيسه ايه؟ مقفوله. طيب كنت باجي الكنيسه الاقي ملا الميه بتاعت القداس، دلوقتي باجي الاقي الميه ايه؟ مش مليانه. كنت باجي الاقي مجهز الاباركه، باجي الاقي الاباركه مش مليانه. كنت باجي الاقي مولع السوريا مش ولعه. كويس؟ فهي spent with us in our church here average of about like 10-11 years. Every single Sunday almost. He used to come early to do a simple service. It's required, it's important. At least I start prayers while the surya and the candles are ready with the oil and the water is here and the barakah is here. And I have somebody around me, I'm not by myself. You understand me? When I start the church by myself, I feel a little disappointed. You know? He used to give me company, give me a hand, give me help. He was not great in the hymns. He didn't know how to help me with the hymns. But he gave me another sort of help. So here is I'm grabbing your attention to a service needed. Who would like to replace Amm Naki is welcome. Okay? If anybody would like to replace him, and to come and to take the blessing, he took it for like more than 10 years. If anybody would like to come and do the same, that would be wonderful. What was his gift? I'm talking from people eyes point of view. What was his gift? What kind of amazing service he was offering to his community? What was he doing? Was it something amazing in people's eyes? No. Maybe it was amazing in God's eyes. Same like Saint Sam'an, when he was delivering water to people, and the God saw his service and his gift as something amazing in his eyes. Glory be to God now and forever. Amen.